Now, we shall now discuss about the other major problems what women are having generally. As I told you before, the education, if you look at the women's education or the girls' education when compared to boys' education, the percentage was 54% when it comes to the girls, when it is compared to the 76% of the boys. Why these kind of scenarios are happening here? This is an actual real calculation and picture. The scene clearly reveals for us that here the parents are willing to spend more money on the boys' education rather than on the girls' education. And very few girls move on to the higher studies. Very few. So this very few percentage does not accommodate the entire girl community. Here the problem is the unequal feeling. The inequality has to be addressed clearly here. There is a lot of inequality happening starting from our home. Even in our neighbor families also, we observe that they give special importance for the boy child when compared to the girl child. Girl child have to be trained to do the household activities even from the early ages, while the boys are not even given any kind of disciplined behavior, mannerl instructions also, even though when they are crossing all the limits of doing indiscipline acts and activities. So these are the basic observations what we observe in our day-to-day life. So in education, the women are completely neglected. Once if you get educated only, you have a chance to go for further higher studies. So the percentage of people going to the higher studies falls to 20 to 25% in the girl community, where it falls nearly 70% in the boys. So when it moves on like this, the number of people getting employed. So once you are educated, you have a chance to get employment. So once you are employed, you have that flexibility to choose your lifestyle, your pattern of living. You can take care of your family, you can do the all the responsibilities, do's and don'ts of your family, whatever is required for you. But here, if the girls are not given the basic education properly, there is no chance for them to go for the higher studies. When they were not allowed to go to the higher studies, that would obviously lead them to turn into the disastrous situation where they have to be dependent on somebody else. The employment opportunities for the women are very, very less. If you take the percentage of people, those who are getting highly paid in a high profile post from the women category, it is very, very less. And the other major defect of even though girls get educated, they get graduated, they get into a job, the amount paid for them is really very less when compared to the men who are there. So even though we have Equal Wages Act also, but this Equal Wages Act is not at all applicable when it comes to the men and women. Let us take in the movies. The film stars, male film stars get more amount paid when compared to the female stars. So this is a common scenario which we find generally in our day-to-day life. Generally, we observe these things. When it comes to sports, we have more craze for male players than the female players. So not only in movies, sports, anything, any category, any section, any field, any time, you consider that men will be paid more when compared to the women. So these kind of divisions and all will enhance the things to happen, and this kind of disparity is present even in India, not only in India, in any corner of the world. So women are not given equal respect. You may get a doubt like, sir, certain CEOs, let's take like for Pepsi or like ICICI Bank, we have certain members being in the top key positions, the position of the MDs, even the SBI directors were also the women. So how do you say that women are not given equal opportunities? If women are not given equal opportunities, why are these people in that particular positions? Your question is 110% right. The problem is we are not talking about the few people who are well placed, well settled, or well utilize the opportunities to grow themselves to a higher position. But the actual thing what we are discussing now, right now, is that the percentage of population of women being placed in a higher talented or a profitable post. As you told now, you may have nearly 2000 to 5000 topmost companies in the world. Out of them, maybe 2% of the companies have women as their CEOs. So the percentage of people working as the CEOs of men is very far better than the women. So that is the point which we are going to highlight here. We are trying to understand it clearly here. So that is the point what I want to tell you here, is that even though there is an act of equal wages, the women do not get paid equally here. That is a major thing here. And later on, we are now falling into a very alarming state where the sex ratio What is sex ratio? The number of females, for every 1000 males is called as sex ratio. Means number of girls to every 1000 boys is called as sex ratio. It is not anything dealt with biologically. It's just the calculation of the terms used to say we have number of girls in competition with 1000 boys. So the number earlier used to be nearly 927 per 1000, whereas nowadays it is going down to 850 per 1000, and later on it fell down. Now in the present calculation it is 800 per 1000. The situations are turning worst, so the things are becoming very drastically changing in respect to the girl child's birth. We have the scenarios, we have the examples where the parents try to find out who is the baby, especially do we have any girl, by doing scannings and all with the mother's womb and all when they were pregnant, and try to know whether, even though if it is legally banned also, they try to make the tests and they try to find out if there is any clue that you may have a girl child. Immediately they would like to go for the abortion or to abort the child. So this kind of abortions reduced the sex ratio of females to males into from 927 to 800. This is really a very genuine situation where we have to react for these kind of things. When we don't react for these kind of things, very soon we observe the number of females to the males will be coming down drastically down, and that would end up finding very less number of girls in our society and in our community. So these kind of things have to be checked thoroughly. And it is now the other important issue, or the other important major problem what we have for the in respect to women, was unsafe situations.